Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. Welcome to Swa Education, myself Radha. And today we are going to start about oil seed processing method. In our previous few lecture, we already discussed barley processing method, in which we discussed barley, malting, breathing, purling method, as well as we also discussed corn processing method, wheat and pulse milling method. And today we are going to discuss oil seed processing method. If you didn't watch that lecture, you can access those lecture very easily from the playlist. So let's start with our today's lecture. Oil seed. So in recent time, oil seed is the most dynamic component of world agriculture in past few decades. Or we can say most growing sector. And the performance of oil seed on the domestic front during the last two decades has been commendable, braving of weather condition, global price aberration, and ever increasing domestic demand. So it's a growing factor or growing world agricultural area, and the self-sufficiency in oil seed attained through Yellow Revolution during early 1990s could not be sustained beyond a short period. Despite being the fifth largest oil seed crop producing country in the world, India is one of the largest importer of vegetable oil today. So fifth largest and largest importer of vegetable oil. There is a spurt in the vegetable oil consumption in recent year in respect of both edible as well as industrial uses. So there is a punctuated equilibrium shows in the oil consumption in recent few year. So there are several kind of varieties of oil seed. It can be sunflower seed, it can be peanut, it can be walnut, it can be sesame seed, almond, it can be pine nuts, wheat germ, ground flax seeds, chia seeds. So there are several varieties of oil seed. And nine oil seed are the primary source of vegetable oil in the country, which are largely growing under rain feed condition over an area of about 26 million. And these nine oil seed, which are the primary source of vegetable oil, are soybean, groundnut, mustard, contribute to more than 88% of total oil seed, and remaining 20% remaining area is covered by mustard, soybean and groundnut. So soybean seed is the world's most important seed legume, which contribute 25% of the global edible oil. You also listen, soybean seed or soybean is the important area or important factor that contribute 25% of edible oil, about 2/3 of world protein concentrate for livestock feeding, and is valuable gradient in the formulated feed for fishes. And the commercial cultivation of soybean crop in India commence in late 60s, starting from 0.32 lakh. In 1970, soybean reached to 101. So we can say it is a growing area. And soybean is predominantly grown as rain feed crop and associated soil with an average crop season rainfall of 900 nanometer, that is the required rainfall for that. And soybean is a short day plant. We will discuss later what is short day plant and what is long day plant. So soybean is short day plant. It has emerged as one of the most resilient rain fed kharif season crop. So soybean is a kharif season crop, and the area under soybean is mainly spread in latitudinal belt of about 15 to 250 comprising the state of MP, Maharashtra, Rajasthan. So these are the area where soybean seed is primarily spreaded. So what is short day plant and what is long day plant? Before understanding this topic, we have to understand what do we mean by photoperiodism. So photoperiodism is made up of two terms, photo plus periodism. Photo means light and periodism means time. That is the meaning of photoperiodism. So photo, on the basis of photoperiodism, there are short day plant, long day plant and day neutral plant. Short day plant, what does it mean? Short day plant means they require more dark condition or night time and less light condition. Let's suppose this is critical photoperiodism of 12 hour. So in first case, this is light condition. Light condition is more than that of dark condition. This is dark condition, this is light condition. And as we say that short day plant only flower when there is a dark condition greater than light condition. But in first case, dark time is less as compared to light time. So that's why short day plant will not flower in this condition. But in second case, this is dark period. Dark period is longer than light period. So short day plant grow or flower in this case when there is a dark period is longer than that of light period. In third case, this is light period, but this is dark condition. But here we provide light or night break with the help of sunlight. So when there is a night break, short day plant will not grow. So these are the conditions that required for the growth of short day plant or for the flowering of short day plant. Means they require longer period of dark time as compared to light time. But when we are discussing about long day plant, they require longer time for light, then they flower. In first case, light condition is longer than dark condition, so long day plant flower. But in second condition, night period or dark period is longer than light period, so in this case they will not flower. And in third case, night break with the help of light, so they will flower. So this is photoperiodism. So on the basis of this photoperiodism, soybean seed is a short day plant. Means they require dark condition more as compared to light condition. Or we can say they are sensitive to day length. So as the case given below, this is dark period and this is longer than light period. So short day plant flower. But in second condition, light period is larger, longer than dark period. So short day plant will not flower. In third condition, dark period is longer than light period, but there is a light provided in between of dark condition. So short day plant will not flower. Clear? So this is the concept of photoperiodism, or we can say short day plant or long day plant. Next one is the oil seed pre-treatment or oil seed processing, in which we discuss cleaning, cracking, conditioning and cooking. So processing of oil seed. First one is cleaning. The first preparation step is cleaning to remove foreign material from the oil seed. So what we do in cleaning, we remove all the dust particle present there. Second one is drying. To remove the hull effective, a moisture content is provided and after that we do drying process. Next one is dehulling. Dehulling operation is performed for the removal of seed coat, which act as anti-nutritional factor, which reduce the nutritional component of oil seed. Conditioning. Conditioning is done with the help of heat and moisture. What we did in conditioning, we provide moisture content, then we will do that particular oil seed sun drying, and after that again we moisturize it. So this is conditioning, where we provide optimum level of moisture content of that particular seed. Next one is extraction. Extraction of oil from the mash is done with the help of screw or centrifugal process, and this method is known as dry method. And extraction of oil can also be done through wet method, where hot water as a liquid is used to extract oil from ruptured cell of oil seed. So extraction method can be done by two process. One is wet method, other one is dry method. These are two method of extraction of oil from the oil seed. So process of oil refining consists of alkali neutralization. Second one is bleaching. What we do in alkali neutralization, we treat the solution, that is called sodium hydroxide, to reduce free fatty acid and polar lipid. Bleaching also an important step of physical refining, and bleaching is performed for the removal of pigment. Deodorizing is done by steam distillation and used for removing products which are volatile. Volatile means gaseous in nature. Fractionation. Fractionation allow the oil to stand for a time at low temperature so that glyceride, which naturally occur in the oil, with higher melting point. Glyceride means glycerol moiety. When we discuss about lipid, we discuss glycerol moiety, phosphoglyceride, glycolipid. So glyceryl, which naturally occur in the oil with a higher melting point, solidify and can be removed from the oil by filtering. This is done by fractionation method. So today we discuss photoperiodism, short day plant as well as long day plant, oil seed processing method and refining method. I hope this lecture is very clear to all of you. So thank you so much everyone. If you find this video beneficial for you, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel for more such kind of videos. And if you have any query regarding this lecture, you can comment down below. Thank you so much.